How do I add a video that I like viewed but not heard into an existing video? That's quite easy. So this is what we call B-roll. So you want to add a video that you can play while you are maybe playing a narration or narrating something, or maybe your introduction or whatever it is. Okay, so it's very easy to do that. And for this, I really like to use the timeline because it's easier. So reveal the timeline, which is at the bottom left there. You've got hide timeline, show timeline. You can click to see it. Reveal that. And I'm just going to assume I want to add an intro video at the beginning. So I'm going to go all the way to the top at the beginning of my video. And I'm going to remove this reggae music here who I played with. And here we go. So I'm just going to quickly create a little space in there. So let's say I want to add a video that I have, like an introduction video. And you go to project. And in here, you have your files. Okay, so if your video is on your hard drive, you drag it onto the files area in here first. And then from here, you can drag it onto where you need it. If you want to add a stock media, those usually don't have sound, so I don't want to use those as an example for this question. But if I have a video that I want to add and I don't want to hear it, let's say this YouTube video that I imported, okay? All you need to do is just grab it and drag it on the left here on top of your timeline. And you can see the video is right there, okay? So you notice that this video now is on a separate layer. It's not on the script track, which is the one at the bottom is called the script track, okay? Anything you transcribe should be there because you want to edit by text. But these videos, B-rolls, extra videos, music, all those things that need to be playing while you're talking or something, they can be as a separate layer. So you notice that this video I just added here has audio because it's a YouTube video, right? It's me talking. So easiest way to mute this is to just click on it. And then, that selects it. And then you go to the layer panel on the right-hand side. It's the layer panel. And the layer panel allows you to then change the properties of whatever you have selected. So I have selected the layer YouTube, that video YouTube, and that is the one that I'm going to change the properties for. And to confirm that, you see at the top, it says YouTube, right? So YouTube means this is the thing that I selected. This is the thing that I'm changing here. And all you need to do is just go to audio and you can click this icon to mute that video file like that, you know? So now that file, you will not hear it. Look, if I play this, you should not hear anything. So the video is muted because I muted it. Usually, I think they used to show that the waveform was gone from there, but it seems like it's now just muting it, but you can still see the waveform. And really, the same thing can be done if you are actually adding the video right there down in the script track. All you need to do is just right click and say include in script. There you go. And now I've got my transcription showing. It unmuted it when I moved it there. But look, I'm selecting it again. Let me just zoom out. So this is where my video now is on the script track. Just look at it down there. The video is down there and click on it and then click mute again. And now the waveform disappears. So different behavior there. If the video is on the script track and it's muted, it doesn't show the waveform. If it's a separate layer, it does show it, you know, a bit of a UI kind of confusion there, but that's how you do it.